Good morning again. Thank you very much for the preparation. This session is talking about discussion about the regional development of the IODE. And in addition to my presentation, there is six presentations, 10 minutes each. I'm sorry for that, but please be short as far as possible. Okay, as a keynote, I'd like to make a presentation a little bit about the regional development of IODE. To save the time, first of all, I'd like to show the conclusion first. My talk is essentially touch on this point. It is substantially important for the promotion of the marine scientific research and services. The important point is to enhance ocean data and information exchange, which was already emphasized by Julian and Vladimir during their presentations. And so more effective and sustainable ocean data and information management should be developed through the closer cooperation between regional subsidiary bodies. And not only the global perspective, but also the regional perspective is quite important for that. The third one is that it is essential for the successful implementation of UN DECADE, the main target of the discussion today and tomorrow. That is important to establish international open access to the ocean data and information, fully taking into account our data policy, which was adopted already year 2003. The principle is a free, open and unrestricted exchange of the oceanographic data. So we have the regional activities within the IODE, which is called ODIN, Oceanographic Data and Information Network. The concept was developed in the 1990s, more than 20 years ago. And there are six ODINs ongoing. And some of them will be touched upon some of the presentation after me. For the ODIN Africa, most successful one, providing the very important opportunity for the African countries, the opportunity of the capacity development of oceanographic data and information management. In this region, I mean the Western Pacific region, we have a subsidiary body called WESPAC. But before WESPAC, we had very successful project called Cooperative Study of the Kuroshio, CSK. During that time, the Japan Ocean Data Center served as a data center called Kuroshio Data Center, which was very successful and by producing the data products, including the publication guide to CSK data. So based on that successful the completion of the CSK, the WESPAC subcommission of IOC now was established in 1979. It was the regional committee for the WESPAC. And then upgraded to the subcommission of IOC in 1989. So with regard to the WESPAC data, there was the responsible National Oceanographic Data Center, RNDC for WESPAC, hosted by Japan Oceanographic Data Center again. For some reasons, we decided to abolish the system of the responsible National Oceanographic Data Centers in year 2005, I guess. And then the part of the responsible National Oceanographic Data Center for WESPAC, a part of the role of the data center have been taken care of by the ODIN WESPAC. And with regard to the term of reference of the responsible National Oceanographic Data Center WESPAC was like this, you know, maintain close cooperation with world data centers at that time, and also enhance the IOD activity in the region. That is the main target of the discussion of this session. Previously, we discussed and promoted the regional framework. Within a regional framework, the IOD activities here through the RDC West Bank activities. The West Bank provided the training courses among the member states of the Western Pacific West Bank. The West Bank training course on oceanographic data and information management since 1982, supported by Japan Funding Trust, provided by the Ministry of Education. And the photo, this is myself. I was one of the lecturers during my younger age, many years ago. But I believe this kind of activities provided a very good, a very unique opportunity for the data managers in the region to know about what is the data management and what is the requirement of the oceanographic data and the information in the region. And then after the abolishment of the responsible national oceanic data center of the West Bank, the pilot project of auditing West Bank established in 2003, initially with the leadership of the Japan Oceanic Data Center, and then reformed in 2007 with the leadership of Dr. Shi Shuixuan, the NMDAS of China. And objective of the project is described like this, and including capacity development in the region in terms of the oceanographic data and information exchange or management. Other regional activities I'd like to mention here is the regional workshop held in almost 20 years ago, held in Langkawi, Malaysia, in 1999, which was aiming at the enhancement of the data and the information management in the region, in close cooperation with the member states in the West Bank. I was there, and also Norio Baba, who is a local host of this meeting, was there. As a local host at that time, he was working for the Malaysian government. So this is a very good initiative for us to promote the data and information management in the region. This is just an example. And Odin West Bank is one of the discussion points during our session starting on Wednesday. We need to reactivate and promote the Odin West Bank in terms of the data management the activities in the region. And we also prepared discussion item at the IOD 25th session of IOD starting on Wednesday, under the agenda item 3.72, which is trying to enhance the cooperation between regional subsidiary bodies and IODE. So I'd like to ask speakers after my presentation, if you have an idea on this kind of issue, please provide some idea. I think the comments are the fully welcome for the discussion at the IOD session. I'd like to talk a little bit about a successful example or in terms of data and information management, which was the World Ocean Circulation Experiment conducted carried out in basically 1990s, which is a global project collect the oceanographic data, oceanographic parameters, mainly physical and chemical parameters, close cooperation among the members of the IOC and other states. This is an example of the section observed during the period of the wars. The important thing of the wars is the global network, world data system like this. The distributed data centers among members of the participating countries of the WAS. For example, Japan Ocean Data Center was responsible for the collection and archival and the publication of the ADCP data, acoustic Doppler current profilers data, and many of the data centers participated in the project. The important point is the data management structure and data management implementation plan was already set at the starting point of the WAS. That is a very important point. And the successful story for WAS was based on the clear data policy and also the data management structure like this. We had the data management committee to monitor the data collection of all over the WAS observations. And afterwards, we had the data products committee to discuss, to design the data products of the WAS. Okay, we had the concluding conference of WAS in San Antonio, United States in 2002. At that time, all of the WAS data are collected and published as WAS global data. At that time, the internet was not very fast, so we decided to publish the data set in a DVD format. And last year, I met one of the active members of the WAS Data Products Committee, who was Rainer Schwitzer, Alfred Wegener Institute of Germany. He said WAS was really successful, particularly in terms of data management and data products. So we need to follow the experiences of WAS. That is the message to the future activities, including UN Decade and other related project and program to follow, to utilize the legacy of the WAS. So before closing my talk, I'd like to just a little touch upon the IoT Ocean Data Exchange Policy. The spirit is stated like this in the preamble part. The timely, free, and unrestricted international exchange of oceanographic data is essential. Then the IOC Oceanographic Data Exchange Policy was adopted as a decision at the IOC Assembly in 2003, I think, after the long and the careful discussion at the Intergovernmental Working Group on Ocean Data Policy, led by the Dr. Angus McEwen from Australia. And we approved this Ocean Data Exchange Policy at the Assembly of the IOC. There are several clauses, but I'd like to touch upon the first one and the fifth one. First one is data under the auspices of the IOC. You can read it. Member states shall provide timely, free, and unrestricted access to all data, associated metadata, and the products generated under the auspices of the IOC programs. That is quite important the clause for us. And number five is also important for us because the member states shall, to best practice degree, practical degree, need to use, as far as possible, we utilize the structure or activities of the IODE for the promotion of the oceanographic data exchange of the IOC. So, to add improved ocean data information management, I'd like to highlight like this. So to facilitate international open access to oceanographic data and information in a timely manner, free based on the spirit or principle of the IOC Oceanographic Data Exchange Policy, and to ensure secure archive for all of such data and information, the possible approach I can suggest particularly at the regional level is to involve data and information management component in Oceanographic Research and Services project from their planning, I mean, very beginning stage. That is quite important for us. After starting point, it is not easy for us to establish the workable detection mechanism. But before starting, we have to discuss about it, or hopefully we can agreed on the implementation plan on the ocean data and information management for the project. Second one is to encourage IOC member states to establish data and information nodes of IODE, including NODCs, and ADU, associated data units, and associated information units. I'm not talking about in detail about it, but IODE would like to expand our network through these activities. And third one is to enhance capacity development activities of oceanographic data in the information management at the regional level. It depends on the requirement of each region, but one of the important aspects is how to develop the capacity in the industry. So the conclusion again. So it is substantially important for us to promote the marine science research and the services. The important point is to enhance oceanographic data and information management, not on the global level, but also the regional level. And more effective ocean data and information management should be developed through closer cooperation between regional subsidiary bodies and the IODE, which will be discussed during the forthcoming session of the IODE this week. And also the regard to the UN Decade of Ocean Science Development, of course, we have to have the workable and effective component of oceanographic data and information management, hopefully before the beginning. Okay, thank you very much for your attention.